say hello, say hello to tomorrow. When you say goodbye to a tangerine sky, you lose your pain, lose your fear, lose your sorrow.
Yo, yo, what is going on, guys? It's your boy, JT Lobster. We're back with a brand new video here. Make sure you guys are subscribing. We're on the road to 100,000 subscribers. All my social medias are below. And let's hop right into this video. If you guys did not know, man, the military is going crazy over this, what people are smoking. Dude, it's apparently a whole new drug. People are getting just blitzed out their mind. I cannot believe this. No, seriously, I read a story about military leaders getting freaked out and banning CBD. CBD. From what I know, dude, seriously, I don't know much about this. I'm actually gonna call my brother, because he actually started a company himself based around CBD. So what better way than to have a residential expert talk about this, because the military's freaking out, saying people are getting high. Yo, you're on the video right now. I'm doing a video on CBD. The military is banning it, saying it gets people high. What do you got to say about that? I told them you're the expert. What do you got to say?
Well, that's very interesting that they banned this thing that gets people high, but that's absolutely not true. It's an essential oil of the cannabis plant, kind of like an essential oil of any plant in this world, like sunflower seed oil.
So, cannabis oil. So there's no THC in the CBD.
No, they're two completely separate chemicals. One of them has nothing to do with getting you high. CBD has nothing to do with getting you high. That's ridiculous.
All right, well, you heard it from the expert. You guys go follow my brother. I'll have all his information linked below. All right, man, thanks a lot.
All right, boyos, you take it easy, guys.
All right, so yeah, the military sometimes gets big sticks up their gooty hole, and I don't know, man. It's very funny, though. There are some actual things, though, that the military has banned when I was active duty. If you guys don't know, blah, blah, blah. If you guys did not know, spice was a huge thing. Like, that stuff is actually super sketchy. It's like synthetic, like drugs, dude, and it'll like mess you up, dude. There was a huge spice bust that went down in my barracks. Someone that worked with my squadron got caught, and he literally just like dominoes went tick, 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 tick. People, dude, heads were rolling. People were getting kicked out. He just gave them all up, every single person that he was doing it with. So yeah, spice, don't mess, like, with bath salts, the synthetic stuff, that stuff is crazy. A lot of people in the military will, like, I did actually know other, you know, people that did smoke marijuana, when they were active duty. You know, if we had, like, a 5-day weekend or a four-day weekend, a 72-hour, they would do it on, like, the Friday, come back to work Monday, and hope they didn't get random urinalysis. Those people are crazy. I would never risk your whole military career on something like that. Sure, it should be out of your system, you know, and like what? If you just do it one time, I imagine a couple days. But it's for some people, if you have like a lot of body fat, that stuff will stay in your fat and then seep out slowly. And I can't believe people would risk it like that, dude. Stay away from spice. Stay away from the synthetic bath salts. Don't risk your military career on something stupid. Just have a beer or two or 10. Drink responsibly. Drink responsibly. Don't get a Dewey, Uber, you know what I'm saying? Have a designated driver. But yeah, this CBD stuff, just thought it was really funny. Like, they're saying, dude, this sailor was high on CBD. And I'm like, dude, I'm pretty sure there's no THC or anything that can get you, you know, under the influence from that. Like, maybe, like, he had a buzz from the nicotine. I imagine, like, if some people, you know, like, I remember the first time I had a cigarette, or I had a Swisher. I had just turned 18. This was before I joined the Navy. I had just turned 18, went to go get, like, a Swisher or something, just tobacco from the store. And that shit, I got dizzy as hell. I got nauseous. I did the same thing when I did my first dip, put in my first little thing in my cheek. What do you call it? You know, get a little scoop to scoop and pack it in there. I don't do that at all. I do not recommend that. Mouth cancer, oral cancer, that stuff scares the shabibers out of me. But like, we were out to sea, deployed. We were out on the catwalk about to go up on the flight deck, and they're like, here, might just put a pinch in. And dude, I had to spit that shit out quick, because I got dizzy. I got messed up. I don't know how some people can like swallow it. Some people swallow the spit. Some people go to sleep with a pinching. That is insane. Do not do that stuff. And if you guys also did not know, they banned, I just picked this up literally at the store, right? I don't do this stuff, dude. I just got it for the video. But this is like a hookah pen. They actually banned like those big e-cigarettes, you know, like the big ones people make with the coils and the juice, and I don't, you know. They banned that stuff on Navy ships because it can apparently spontaneously combust. I know there's cases of, like, I've heard in the news of those e-cigarettes or like the big things that people get, like combust in someone's pocket or combust in the car. So obviously if that happens on a Navy ship, that's a huge fire hazard. Anything that can cause a fire is a no-no, a no-go. So they actually also banned on the Lincoln, when I was on the Lincoln, you couldn't have outlets in your rack. Apparently it's a fire hazard. So, you know, it's just unfortunate because a lot of people are now gonna just go and smoke cigarettes. And that stuff is no bueno. If you have not seen a smoke pit, if you have not been in a smoke pit or seen a smoke pit on a Navy ship, it is disgusting, dude. You will come out of there reeking like for hours. It's so bad. A lot of them are enclosed. It's literally an enclosed smoke pit on the ship. Like, only E6 or E7, E7 and above, the chiefs on the carriers that I was on had a smoke pit that was exposed. Like, that was, you know, you can look out to sea. It was open air smoke pit. But the ones for enlisted personnel, that shit was enclosed. It was gross. So, just a funny little story. I appreciate all the support, man. We're on the road to 100K. Make sure you guys are leaving a thick like and a comment. Also, if you guys did not know, I have a Patreon. It's in the description. I want to give a huge shout out to some recent pledges to James, Eric, and Wesley. You guys, man, thank you so much for all the support. Incredible. I really appreciate you guys. I'll see you very soon. Brand new videos almost every day. And also, the Patriots just lost the Super Bowl. I was rooting for the Pats because I'm a diehard Giants fan, and I hate the Eagles with a passion. I hate to see it happen. My boy Tom, you know, I want it to be the only team, the Giants, that have beat Tom Brady in the Super Bowl. But now the Eagles can say that as well. All right.